Hello, welcome to church. Welcome to St. Andrew's from the balcony today. The balcony that offers this beautiful perspective and this beautiful light. We're having one of those gorgeous Nova Scotia spring days where the light has a kind of warmth and intensity to it. But it's strange because at the same time as the light is coming in through these windows, just outside, the streets are eerily quiet because we've moved into a province-wide lockdown for COVID. And so there's this odd perspective happening as I'm standing here and talking with you from this sanctuary. I'm really glad for that reason, especially, that you're joining us for this worship, that we can gather together in this way. You know, church is obviously not about location or buildings or even beautiful sanctuaries like this. It's about the people. It's about the people who come through the door, virtually or physically, to be together in community and to explore faith together. And it's also about the people who never come through the door, who never will come through that door, whether virtually or physically, but are impacted by who we are and what we do and how we live out our faith in the world. That's what it's about. And so I'm really glad that you've joined us today. Thank you. Kevin and I were talking about online worship during the lockdown, and we had this conversation about perspective and how perspectives change in times like this. How exactly is not always clear, but here's what we've come up with. We're going to do a worship series, three parts, that will be, we hope, the duration of the lockdown in Nova Scotia. And we're going to call it Fresh Perspectives. And we are going to take you into a different location every Sunday in this building. And it will be a location, I guarantee you, that you have not been in before. Even those of you who've been coming to this building for worship for decades. What we hope is that the different perspective will allow our spirits and our praise to open to the new perspectives that God calls us to, that just might equip us to deal with this changing world that we live in and the circumstances that we find ourselves facing. So in a moment, I'm going to take you somewhere in the sanctuary. But first, let's gather ourselves into the presence of God, wherever we are, through prayer and a hymn. Let us pray. Holy God, open each one of us where we are, as we are, to encounter with you this morning, this day. Encounter with the word and the words, encounter with the songs and the singing, encounter with the praying and the praising. Open us, God, in the various locations and circumstances, in the various needs and hopes that we have. Bring us into the presence of you and loving community. It is in Christ's name that we gather and we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
church is about the people and the holistic fostering of body, mind, spirit, and possibility. And then bringing those things into the perspective of balance and harmony and connection within and among. Welcome to the belly of the organ, the source of sound. Let's talk about the spirituality of music. This is such a cool place, and music is such an important part of what we do in this place, such an important part of our tradition, of our religion. And not only that, it's an important part of our entire existence. Why is that? Because music is spiritual. Music moves us and enchants us. Music energizes us, but it also can calm us down. Music can heal us. It touches us, right? We can feel it. And as much as music can do those sort of beautiful things to our lives, it can also do painful things, bring out the pain in us, the lamentation, cause us to have tears. Music can even disrupt us or disorient us. It can take us to unexpected places. Making music and listening to music is such a powerful experience. It can be. But it can also be completely ordinary, just an everyday kind of thing, right? It can be a driving in the car kind of thing, or a doing housework kind of thing, or curling up with your sweetheart kind of thing, a being together kind of thing. You have to love that music is one of those aspects of our lives that we can do in a completely solitary and personal experience kind of way, or we can do it in a communal way, a connective way. There's nothing like being in a room with a whole bunch of other people and hearing a great performance, knowing that you're all hearing the same music, that it's going in you and through you, and that there's this energy that just runs through the room. You can feel it. It's spiritual, truly spiritual. You know, making music can be like that. If we have the chance to do it, where we bring our voices together with other voices, you know, in this sort of like this, where all the different sounds, all the different colors, all the different pitches and depths and qualities of the voices come together and we make music together. It's very connective, very spiritual experience. All those things that I just said could be said about prayer, music and prayer, both spiritual. So prayer, it can move us and enchant us. It can energize or calm. It can heal us, for sure. Prayer can disturb us, bring out the pain in us. It can disrupt us and take us to unexpected places. And it can be this very personal and solitary experience, but beautifully, it can also be a communal experience. And both are good. Both are actually necessary in our lives. And another thing that we could say about prayer and music in the same way is that it is as natural to us as breath. Don't say to me that you quit piano lessons at, you know, age 7 and your choir director told you to just mouth the words, which I hate hearing as a music teacher. Music is as natural to us, to you and to me and to all of us, as to breath. Something divine gave us this mysterious, extraordinary gift of music, and it started at the moment of your creation. It started in the womb. When that collection of cells that makes you you, that collection of cells was being formed and accompanied by the rhythm of your mother's heartbeat. You were formed accompanied by rhythm. of your mother's heartbeat, which is music. And then over time, the rhythm of your heartbeat was able to join with the rhythm of her heartbeat, and music was made together. And the extraordinary thing is that that heartbeat that you could feel right now if you put your hand to your chest, that rhythm is virtually the same rhythm as what I'm experiencing in my heart and in all hearts, everywhere. And if we want to extend it far enough to the universal heartbeat of God, its rhythm, there is this Sufi mystic. His name is Hazrat Khan, and he writes about the universality of music. And one of the things that he wrote about in terms of singing, he said something along the lines of the voice. Man will say that the voice comes from the throat and from the spine. The mystic will say that the voice comes from the soul and the divine. Virtually all religious traditions use rhythm and melody and music, solitary singing, listening, and communal singing. Virtually all religious traditions, with except maybe a few, that use silence. And Kevin Parks would say that silence is music, and that silence is an intrinsic part of rhythm. But if you just think about it, sitting now in your house, if you just think about out there, there is this vibrant, sacred soundscape out there all the time that's coming from churches and temples and mosques and synagogues and meeting halls and from around sacred fires, coming from all manner of spiritual places all the time. It's an extraordinary thing, really, to think about. And yet at the same time, because it's spiritual, it's absolutely ordinary and universal. That same spirituality is part of our everyday lives, our existence all the times. It's part of our homes. It's part of our bars and coffee shops. It's part of our earphones whenever we put them in and tune them on. And so the goodness of that is that it's a reminder that the spiritual is always there for us to receive. It can be part of our lives, it can accompany us and infuse us everywhere, even when we can't come to church. I want to offer you three quotations. These quotes are not taken from scripture. They are taken from Jerry Garcia of the Grateful Dead, B.B. King, blues master, and Harlan Howard, country musician. Jerry Garcia of the Grateful Dead said, "We need music. I don't know why. We need magic and bliss and power and myth and celebration and religion in our lives, and music can encapsulate all of it." That's a good quote. B.B. King said, singing about your sadness will unburden your soul. Singing about your sadness will unburden your soul. And Harlan Howard said, country music is three chords and the truth. Music is spiritual. Music is as natural to all of us as breath. Let's listen.
Through us, through walls, and the
I miss singing with you when we can't be all together. The songs of praise and thanksgiving and love and wonder and lamentation and commitment and call. I miss all those songs singing with you, singing in harmony, singing in unison. Are you one of the brave ones who, even though you're home and you're on your own, that you actually sing along with your computer? That's very cool. Even if you're not one of the brave ones, I hope that when we get back together again, when we're able to gather again, that you will sing out, that you will let your voice join with other voices. It's such good connection, and it makes good community, and we need both. St. Ambrose said, I cannot hold a grudge against the one whom I join my voice in song. You know, when we sing together, we have to listen to one another, right? We have to hear each other and stay in sync with one another. And we have to find the rhythm that is kind of underneath us and going with us in what it is that we're trying to do together there. The balance that we need to have with one another. It's good practice for community and family and relationships. How do you make a sound as a community? How do you work with others? How do you listen to others and hear others and help yourself to be heard with others so that you're in some kind of harmony? I mean, if that's not practical for life, the formation of community. Many times with choirs and ensembles, they form a real bond through music making. It happens with our choir here at St. Andrew's. They are truly a community within a community. Out of music making, they're in a kind of relationship. They care for one another. They watch out for one another. They support and encourage one another. It's good for relationships. They find some kind of harmony in what they're doing. And in some ways, they learn to love one another. And the mostly righteous, do you know what they do? They have a process. They come together, they get together, not just to learn songs, but to collaborate, to brainstorm ideas and theology and spirit in a way that gets explored through music, but also that builds this relationship among them that we get to participate in and join in on a Sunday morning. Yeah, sometimes these kinds of music making builds far more than just a great performance. Sometimes our sound as a community doesn't sound as harmonious as it should be. It's disharmonious, right? Or it's out of sync. Sometimes making a sound as a community, you notice that someone's really flat, or someone's really sharp, or someone's too loud and not helping others to be heard. All these are lessons for community and family and relationships, and we need to practice and let the music and the voices come together in at least some approximation of balance and harmony and connection as best we can. But definitely we need to practice in a way that gives every voice life. It lets every voice sing. I love it up here, even though it's like super dusty and there's a bee that keeps flying around my head. I love it because like all these pipes, right? All the different sizes, all the different shapes, all the different sounds, just waiting to be heard, waiting to come together in beautiful song. Waiting to come together in beautiful song. Listen, stay tuned for the postlude because Kevin Parks is gonna make these pipes sing.
Changing, your love is a mountain, burning beneath my feet.
come together in prayer and try not to feel too far away. God knows exactly where we are. Let us pray. Holy and present God, hear our prayers, hear our voices, each one unique, each one known by you. God, in this period of pandemic, we are in need of your help. May it infuse our spirits, help us to gain fresh perspective, help us to find a balance and a rhythm, especially in this time of shutdown. God, when we are receiving updates and changes every day, when the news is just so terrible coming out of India and Halifax, God, help us to stay calm. Help us to discern what it is that is being asked of us in this time. God, when fear makes it hard for some of us to breathe and anxiety seems to be the order of the day, slow us down. Help us to help one another. Let our spirits touch one another. Help us to reach out with our hearts, even when we can't touch with our hands. Give us the confidence and the courage to be socially connected, even when we have to be socially distant. God, help us to love as perfectly as we can right now, knowing that perfect love does cast out all fear, and we have love to give. Holy God, we pray especially for all who are sick and all who are grieving and all who are serving the sick and serving the grieving. We ask your blessing and your grace upon them. God, we pray for our nearest and dearest, the nearest and dearest to our hearts, if not our proximity. God, we pray for their safety. We pray for their health, emotional, physical, spiritual health. And we pray for their wholeness. And we pray these same things for ourselves, that you might be with us. Body, mind, spirit, possibility, keeping us whole, keeping us grounded in the rhythm that is the heartbeat of all and the heartbeat of you. And hear our disparate voices, God, as we bring them together to pray this. Our Mother, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen and amen. This is a blessing for you. May the love of God, may the fellowship of Holy Spirit, and may the peace of Christ be with you, go with you, stay with you, wherever you are. Go in peace to sing. Amen.